just as you are. Hear the Spirit call. Come just as you are. Come and see. Come receive. Just as you are, hear the Spirit call. Come just as you are. Come and see. Come receive. Don't you hear the Spirit call? Come just as you are. Come and see Christ my King. Come and live forever.
This is the life I've always wanted, to know the Prince of Peace, and to feel my faith restored as your grace surrounds me. This is a day of new beginnings. This is where my freedom's starts. And now death has lost its sting. And Jesus, how can I thank you?
Just to know that you love me gives me hope to carry on.
What can this world do to me? No, no.
Just to know that you're with me on all these roads I travel on.
When all I have is gone, I confess my dependence on you. There's a lightness in my laughter. There is a joy inside my soul. My heart is overwhelmed. And Jesus, how can I thank you?
Just to know that you love me gives me hope to carry on.
What can this world?
Happy Father's Day, all you dads out there. Hope you folks are having a beautiful day. It's getting towards what? Did it today? June 20 already. It's almost the end of the month and half a year. It almost have just flown by. But we want to praise and thank God for this day. We want to thank God for all our dads, all our fathers, And I hope you guys are having some grills barbecuing today. And well, very yet, not yet. No go barbecue. Take your dads out to lunch or something, eh? Or barbecue for your father. All right. Anyway, we're gonna get into the worship because we want to celebrate Happy Father's Day to our Father in Heaven too, and praise and worship Him. We praise and thank You for this beautiful day. All right. Thank You, Lord, for all of our dads. Oh yeah. He came to live a perfect life. He came to be the living Word of life. He came to die so we'd be reconciled. He came to rise to show His power. Cause He gave His everything. Cause He gave His everything. That's not Jesus calling. He came to live and in us. He came to be a conquering king. Just singing out. God for this beautiful day. Yes, He gave us everything. He gave us our fathers, gave us our mothers, and He gave us this beautiful day to worship Him. So let's continue to worship Him. Excuse me. I lost my train of thought because of that note. Follow You. It is a cry of my heart. He goes. open my eyes so I can see the wonderful things that you do. For this beautiful day, Lord, we come to worship you this morning. We give you all of our praise and all of our attention. And Lord, block all the calls and all the texts that's coming in right now, because we want to focus solely on you this morning and worship you and give you a full attention in worship that you deserve. When the music fades and all is stripped away, and I simply come, longing just to bring something that's a word that will bless your heart. I'll bring you more than a song, for a song is it's not what you require. You search much deeper within, through the way things appear. You're looking into my heart. I'm coming back to the heart of worship, but it's all King of endless worth, no one could express how much you deserve. Though I'm weak and poor, all I have is yours, every single breath. Now bring song on itself, it's not that you require. You search much deeper within, to the way things appear. You're looking straight in my heart. I'm coming back to the heart of worship, but it's all about you, Lord. It's all about you, Jesus. I'm sorry. It's all about you, yes, Lord. I'll bring you more than a song. I'll bring you more than a song. More than a song, yes, I'll bring. Let's do that again. Come on, I'll bring you. I'll bring you more than a song. I'll bring you more than a song. More than a, I'll bring you, yeah. I'll bring you more than a song. I'll bring you more than a song. More than a song. Sing with me now. You're looking into my heart, looking into my heart, into my heart. You're looking into my heart, looking into my heart, into my heart. One more time, sing with me now. Looking into my heart, into my heart, yeah. You're looking into my heart, you're looking into my heart, into my. It's all about you. It's all about you, Jesus. I'm coming back to the heart of worship. When it's all about you, Lord. It's all about you, Jesus. I'm sorry, Lord, for the things I made. Lord, it's all about you. Oh, it's all about you. I'll bring you more than a song. I'll bring you more than a song. More than a song. I'll bring you more than a song. Bring you more than a song. It's all about you, Jesus. It's all about you, Lord. Our main focus this morning. We focus all our eyes, all our hearts, and all of our mind upon you. Lead the way, Lord. Take full control. Because you are here, moving in our midst. I worship you. I worship you. As you are here working in this place, I worship you. I worship you. Sing with me. You are here moving in our midst. I worship you. I worship you. You are here working in this place. I worship you. I worship you. 'Cause you are rainmaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. Yes, you are waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. You are here turning lives around. I worship you. Worship you. As you are here, oh, healing every heart. I worship you, Lord. I worship you. You are way maker, miracle worker, oh, promise keeper, light in the darkness. Yes, you are waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. 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 That you never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop, you never stop working. You never stop, let's do that again. Yeah, even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop, you never stop working. You never stop. Stop working, even though when I don't see it, you're working, Lord. Even when I don't feel you working, you never stop, you never stop working. You never stop, you never stop working. Oh, Lord, you never stop.
Hallelujah.
Let us give God the praise this morning. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you for your love and your praises, your worship. Well, praise God this morning. Aloha. If you just joined us, welcome. Hope you had, folks had a great rest. And it's Father's Day. So we'd like to send a shout out to all our dads out there and have a great, beautiful day. But hey, speaking of fathers, I want to give God the glory this morning. But do me a favor, just go around and greet each other this morning. We have a few guys on got up early this morning to worship with us. So join us and greet each other this morning. Is that okay? All right. Happy, 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 happy are the people whose God is Lord. Happy, 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 happy are the people whose God is with us. This happy feeling come from where? Jesus, with us. Away from this happy feeling comes from Jesus. Every day is more than pleased. That's where this happy feeling. Kabu, all the way from Molokai. Happy, good morning. Happy, good morning, man. Happy, happy, happy are the people's God. Come on, here, Molokai's in the house. God, thank you, Jesus. Huh? Well, I ain't pulling within the worship this way, but we can pull it right now. Let's pull it right now. Okay? Kalamayau, if I missed the pulley that you're so used to. Hey, Kalamay, let us pull it. Let us pray. Jehovah Himalele kia kua ika hiko ia. Ika nani ka ihi ihi ameka hano hano. Ke ho mai kai ke ozana ke mililani a ho ho ako ni a mako ia oi. No laila. E lo mai oi ka poikawa. Ia koko mai nei. E ho mai kai a mako. A me ka mako ma ohana. A e launa pu mai ko u hane he malele. Me mako I ko liki ai. Ka mako lave lave ana. Me kau I make make ai. No laila. E ho anani ia ai oi I loko kai noa. O come a quirky cake, a meko honey him a lily. O holy Jehovah, the God is filled with splendor, sacredness, and glory. We thank, we praise, and we glorify thee. Therefore, have mercy upon us who are gathered together. Bless us and our work. And let your Holy Spirit abide with us, that we may be able to do your work according to your will. Therefore, we praise thee in the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. All right. Well, we got some announcements, I believe. And I'm going to try and do this as I can't see it. But every Tuesdays is Bible studies, and it begins at 6 o'clock. And I believe we're in, like, 1 Corinthians. Didn't I fix that? Oh, my gosh. I'm so behind. We're actually, I believe, like on chapter 9. Yeah, I think we're on chapter 9 now. I don't know if my sister can correct me on that, but I believe we're on chapter 9. If you can join us, we were so blessed to have our Ohana all the way from Las Vegas joining us too now. So we had so my cousin Pucci and her son Miles joined us. So our Bible study is kicking up. I think we're up to like what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We're about 8 now. We just jumped up 2 more. So I want to praise and thank God for our Bible studies. And it's the conversations are awesome. The way we do Bible studies is like a conversation where everybody puts in their input and we talk about it. And until we're all satisfied that we understand what the scripture is. So I want to praise and thank God that he allows us to do Bible studies even through Zoom. So that the more the merit that gets in there and feeds into the conversation, then we you know, like they say, iron sharpens iron. Two or three heads are more better than just one. So I want to praise and thank God for that. Also coming up, what else we got there, Roy? Oh, yes. We want to let you know that we're not being able to do a live worship there because they just don't want too much people in there that morning. Yeah, because it's about the liability and stuff. So we had to stop doing it and go back to doing it online. But we are still keeping it, and we're praising God that he put us there for a reason. And so we're going to try and see what we can do within this ministry center. And we have a ministry shelf right now set up that we we're providing free Bibles and whatever journals that I can put together. We want to provide free Bibles and journals so people can start doing devotions and getting to know Jesus. We also have daily breads there that will be on the stands. And if you can see the little picture, that's kind of like our little center right now, our little ministry center in one of the booths. But in that booth, we also do a fundraising every Saturday. We're so blessed to have Peter from Ohia Bread, Ohia Bakery, and providing us with breads and cookies. And our, you know, and I like to say mahalo to our Ohana, our keikis, and just for people donating baked goods. We had a baked good last week, and this week we had bread and cookies. And I want to praise and thank all the everybody who came down to support us to purchase. I mean, I just sold the last 4 breads this morning that they came to my house. So yeah, so we're blessed. The last 3 is already sold here that I'm going to take right after church. So God is providing. I mean, it's really not. It's that the fundraiser we do helps to pay for the boots that we can provide services there, ministry service. So we'll be doing a lot of good stuff. We pray for people if they can come down. We're going to create a prayer box too. If we're not there, they can fill out a prayer card, stick it in a box, and we can get there and pray for people's concerns and needs. And, you know, Roy was there too during the week. He gave away a couple of Bibles. He prayed for a brother. And it's the more they get to know that we're there, we're going to reach more people. So I want to praise and thank God for this opportunity and finding the reason that God put us into this place called Ohana Holly Marketplace. So I want to praise and thank God for Tiny Tadani and the owner, Chris Ulu, for allowing us to do ministry in there. So, oh, and Brother Raymond, yes, Brother Raymond. I'm not sure of his last name, but I want to thank them for allowing us to do ministry in this place. And it's so awesome because the all the people that come there regularly, they're really happy about it, and they enjoy, you know, the fellowship. So come on down and join us every Saturday. We'll be there doing the bread. We'll be playing music on Wednesdays there at the main stage. Pineapple squeeze juice, yeah. Wednesdays, you're going to do nothing. Come on down. Also, what else we have there in our... What is next? Oh, yes. We're going to do a men's fellowship. And you see, we're going to take it out of Zoom and put it right there at Ohana Hale. And we're going to change the time to about 2:30 at the Ohana Hale Marketplace. We got two booths, so we're going to use one for ministry and one for our church office. And so I want to do men's fellowship with men there. We're inviting anybody. It doesn't matter if you belong to our church or even go to church. If you want to come and fellowship and just talk about stuff, we're going to talk about stuff, and we're going to apply God's word to the stuff that we deal with. So, and it's perfect that I brought this out now because it's Father's Day. So all you dads out there, come on down. Join us. Join me and Roy. We're there like Saturdays doing our fundraiser. And about 2 o'clock, it kind of cools down. So I figured about 2:30, we can do our fellowship for about an hour. And, yeah, so come on down. Join us. We want to praise and thank God for that. And also, what else do we have? Is that it? Oh, yes, yes, yes. So, yeah, so speaking of which, we're allowed to do fundraisers, and it's awesome so that we can raise money for ministry. Not just to pay for our boots, but we want to do a whole lot of other stuff. Like we got our Ziploc ministry and, you know, going out to the community and giving back needs, Bibles. We want to thank God for people donating Bibles already. We're going to thank Pastor Sam Kapu and Jamie Kapu, who donated like 3 boxes of Bibles. And you know, it's weird how God works, because my wife said that Sam told her, yeah, I never know why he had to bring these Bibles home. And so now they knew that was the reason. And that's how it's been going ever since we've been in this ministry. I want to also mahalo to Tessa Balos, who's been like blessing us with stuff to help us set up this ministry. She even blessed me with oil so that we could bless the boots. Oh, yes. And she even blessed us with citrus, the cleaner, because we forgot it at home. I said, no, just take this, and so we could clean the place. And you know, my wife was on her knees scrubbing the walls, scrubbing the floors. And yeah, it works wonders, because everybody came by and said, wow, you guys got the cleanest boot here. So I want to praise and thank God for all of them that and along with this ministry, we're also going to put in, I want to put in like a roving bookshelf. So along with giving away Bibles or people who need Bibles and journals, I just got a lady that's going to donate about 4 boxes of Christian books, books, and I think was VHS and stuff. It's all free. She's donating all of these. So I'm going to go down and pick that up, and I'm going to pick up another shelf. And so we're going to kind of create a ministry center where people can come. They can grab a book. They can take it. They can, if you want to leave a book, you can leave a book on this shelf. If you're there and you want to, you know, you go buy your coffee, come over there. We're going to put a couple of tables, a couple of chairs, so that you can sit there. You can do your devotion, your quiet time. You can read, or you can just fellowship with whoever is there. So God is really good, and we want to praise and thank God. And, yeah, so, you know, join us. Come on down and check it out. I mean, there's so much you can, you know, the food is awesome. I mean, you get so much to choose. That's the hardest part of our day, is trying to see what you like to eat. Oh, I don't know what you like to eat. And, you know, me and Roy was thinking what we like to eat. And what was there? People was bringing us samples of food, and by the time we was ready to go buy food, we was full already. But I want to praise and thank God for this opportunity to do ministry right there at Ohana Hale. For those of you out of town in the mainland, when you come to Hawaii, come check us out. Come down to our ministry. It's nice to see your smiley faces in person other than just online. But we thank and appreciate all of you who join us every Sunday online. Hey, there's Pam Kutzen on there. Hi, Pam. Yeah, she's down there too. Go check her out. All right. Shall we get into it? Do I have anything else? We have a special, right? Yeah. Did I get all the bulletins? Okay. We got a special, and what's the name of these guys? Nakaneola. Nakaneola. They come from the windward side of the island. And since it was, they did a special for us a couple weeks back. And since it was Father's, I thought it would be great because this is just four men singing worship. So we're going to turn it over to them, Nakaneola. And here's a special for all of our dads.
In times like these, you need a Savior. In times like these, you need an anchor. Be very sure. Be very sure. Your holds and grips the solid rock. This rock is Jesus. Yes, He's the one. This rock is. Solid rock. In times like these, you need a Bible. In times like these, oh, be not idle, be very sure.
Gentlemen, all the way from Kaneohe Congregational Church, and I believe that this year they celebrated 185 years. Praise the Lord. 185 years. So mahalo to Nakani Ola and the men from Kaneohe Congregational Church. That's awesome. What a song, eh? Was that anybody's song? In times like these, yes. Sorry, color my yellow. And by the way, if you guys are wondering, yes, I'm solo today. My wife is still under the weather. So I'm going to pray for her and have the Lord to heal her. Because she just got called to go back to work on Tuesday. So I want to pray that the Lord heals her and she can go back to work. Not that I want her to go back and get rid of her, but, you know, just that, you know, she's been waiting over a year to go back to work. So praise God for that. Let us go to our word for today. Our scripture reading is found in our New Testament, in the Gospel of Matthew. Matthew, the first book in the New Testament. Matthew chapter 10. Yes, and I'm only going to read this in English because our little Hawaii girl is not feeling well. And I don't want to make you guys laugh too much today. So, Matthew chapter 10, verses 26 to 31. All right? I'm going to read this from the NIV version. So, if you got your Bibles, pull them out. Test my copying of the scriptures. Make sure the word is right. And let us read the word. Verse 26. So do not be afraid of them, for there is nothing concealed that will not be disclosed, or hidden that will not be made known. Verse 27. What I tell you in the dark, speak in the daylight. What is whispered in your ear, proclaim from the roofs. Do not be afraid of those who kill the body, but cannot kill the soul. Rather, be afraid of the one who can destroy both soul and body in hell. Verse 29. Are not two sparrows sold for a penny? Yet not one of them will fall to the ground outside your Father's care. And even the very hairs on your head are all numbered. So don't be afraid. You are worth more than many sparrows. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Lord, we just thank you for the scripture that you provided for us this morning, Lord. And Lord, may it speak to us. So let us open our minds and our hearts to receive the blessings you have for us on this day. Let us not just hear your words. Let it soak deep down into our hearts, but not stop there. Let us go from our ears to our hearts, to our hands and our feet, and go in our mouths to share the word that you have for us today, Lord. Bless the hearts that are here to receive you. Bless our fathers. And may my words and my thoughts be your thoughts this morning, not mine. But we give you all the glory and we give you all the honor. And Lord, we say happy Father's Day to you because you are our Father. And we are your child, your children. And we love you. We pray all this in your precious name. Amen. Twack! I looked up and craned my ear toward the sound. Spotting a smudge on the window pane, I peered out onto the deck and discovered the still beating body of a bird. And my heart hurt. I longed to help the fragile, fettered being. Well, in Matthew 10, Jesus described his Father's care for sparrows in order to comfort the disciples as he warned of upcoming dangers. He warned them of upcoming dangers. And he offered instructions to the 12 as he gave them authority to drive out impure spirits and to heal every disease and sickness. While the power to do such deeds might have seemed grand to the disciples, many would oppose them, including governing authorities, their own families, and the trapping grip of the evil one. So Jesus told them not to fear whatever they faced, because they would never be out of their Father's care. Are not two sparrows sold for a penny, he asked. Yet not one of them will fall to the ground outside your Father's care, he says. So he says, don't be afraid. You are worth more than all these sparrows. I checked on the bird throughout the day, each time finding it alive but unmoved. Then, late into the evening, it was gone. I prayed it had survived. Surely, if I cared this much about the bird, God cared even more. Imagine how much he cares for you and for me. Now, scripture today, I'm going to break this up into, I think it's just two. Yeah, just two sections. Okay. And the first section, we're going to take from verses 26 to 28. And it's this section is boldly proclaim the message. We're going to talk about to boldly proclaim the message. Yeah. In verse 26 to 28, it says, do not be afraid of them, for there is nothing concealed that will not disclose, or hidden that will not be made known. Yeah, what I tell you in the dark, speak now in the daylight. What I whispered in your ear, proclaim it from the rooftops. Don't be afraid of those who kill the body but cannot kill your soul. Rather be afraid of the one who can destroy both your body and soul in hell. We should be bold to proclaim what? The gospel. Yeah? We should be bold to proclaim the gospel. That's the message. The gospel, the word of the Lord. Not to be afraid of any persecution, because God is warning the disciples. If you know the scripture, it talks about Jesus is warning his disciples that he wants them to go out and proclaim the gospel now. Now is the time, he said. Up until then, he was training them. He was teaching them. Sometimes he was teaching them in the quiet, in the dark, and he whispers. But now he's telling them it's time for you to step it up. It's time for you to get out of the dark and get into the daylight. Yeah? It means whatever was hidden, now I want it to be seen. I want it to be known. Proclaim it from the rooftops. Mean to go out and share the gospel. And that's what God calls us to do. He said, don't be afraid of, because we're going to find people going to judge you. You find people judging you for every little thing now. Everything they want to judge you. Look, they just was judging Augie T. That something that was recorded years ago. Yeah, everybody used to laugh about it back then. Now it's a big thing because he's a politician now. And that's how it's going to be. You know, now that you become a Christian and you start proclaiming the gospel, you're going to run into that same kind of persecution, the same kind of rejection. And sometimes you're going to be rejected or persecuted from your own family or from even maybe your spouse or your children. Yeah? And God is telling us today not to be afraid. To step out of the box, step out of your comfort zone, pop your bubble, and share the word, share the gospel. Don't be afraid. God sees and he knows all that is happening. He knows what's going on. He knows that you're going to be persecuted. He knows that you're going to get rejected. But what is that? I always remember the entrepreneur thing, yeah? In order to succeed, sometimes you're going to fail the first 20 times, yeah? And then you finally get somebody. I remember a pastor always saying, he goes, He goes to church to preach the word, whether people are there or not. You never know the day that you know show up, somebody will walk in there needing the word. Yeah? And that's what God is telling us. Don't be afraid of what's going on. Don't be afraid of rejection, because you know what? You just keep doing what I tell you, because you don't know what's happening. You don't know what's gonna appear that God's gonna provide or put in front of you at that specific time. And sometimes we need to just trust things we cannot see or know. Yeah? But to trust God, you know, like how we trust in God, why are we there? I mean, they shut us down from doing the worship, but what? Hey, God said you can still spread the gospel. So are we going to trust him, or are we just going to give up? And the word is telling us right here, he's telling us straight. God sees and he knows what's happening. He sees your heart and your desire to serve him. And he sees the love that you have for others. So he says to his disciples, continue to boldly proclaim the gospel. He says, continue. He's telling us today, continue what you started out to do. Don't let things stop you from pursuing the work that God called you to do. He says, your reward, he will reward you. He says he will reward us for our faithfulness. He will reward us for our faithfulness. He will also punish those who reject the gospel. So you shouldn't be afraid of people who persecute you, reject you. You should feel sorry for them, because God is going to punish them. And he's going to reward you for continuing to share the gospel. Let me share with you a scripture in Matthew 5. From the Beatitudes itself, straight out of the Beatitudes, verse 10 to 12. It says, blessed are those who are persecuted because of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. In 11, it says, blessed are you when people insult you, persecute you, and falsely say all kinds of evil against you because of me, he says. In verse 12, he says, he continues on. And I like that he always encourages us after, you know, an issue like that when it persecutes you. But he comes back and he says in verse 12, rejoice and be glad. Why? Because great is your reward in heaven. For in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you. Church, whatever you're dealing with today, sharing the word of God is nothing. You know that all the disciples, yeah, they shared the gospel. They followed Jesus. But you know that all of them, they had some brutal, they died brutally. You know, some of them was stoned. What else? Persecuted, imprisoned. Paul was imprisoned. Yeah, all of these disciples had some of the kind. Some hard way of dying. But you know what, man? Their reward is in heaven. And that's the awesome thing that Jesus comes back and say, rejoice. Rejoice for sharing the gospel, and rejoice for being persecuted. You know why you should rejoice for being persecuted? Because if you're being persecuted for his sake, you're on the right path. Yeah? You need to think about this. Because you know why? You're being persecuted because the devil doesn't want you to succeed. Amen? The devil doesn't want us to succeed. So he puts people and tries to shut you down. And the thing is, if we're gonna be afraid of that and just walk away, or we're gonna stand up for our God and say, you know what? That's okay. It's okay. Because God still has a plan. Because you know what? The last time I checked, he's still in control. So maybe he wasn't there for a specific reason. Because we don't know why God put you in a place or in a position to do something on his behalf. Yeah, we're just humble servants following his lead. It's when we follow our lead, we're going to run into trouble. Yeah? But whenever you get persecuted, you get shut down, or you get stopped, it's because the devil doesn't want you to succeed. Amen? He wants you to fail. The devil wants you to fall, fail, and be destroyed. That's what he is, to kill and destroy. Kill, tear down, and destroy. That's the devil's job. So if you're going through these times, God said to what? Be bold. Don't worry about them. Your reward is in heaven. Just continue to do, because I see what's going on. I know what's happening. I know your heart. Your heart's going to be rewarded in heaven. These guys, not. And that's why we should feel sorry for them and continue to pray for them. Yeah? We continue to pray for them because we don't want to be in their position. And we want them to understand they don't want to be in that position. So I want to praise and thank God that God shares the scripture with us. He tells his disciples what he taught them in private. He says, now to go out, proclaim it publicly. He wants us to bring the light into the darkness of this world. He wants us to share the light. Boldly share the gospel and glorify God aloud. You don't have to be ashamed to say God is good, because God is good all the time. Let me share with you one more scripture. In Psalms 100, this is my favorite scripture. This is one of my first scriptures that other than, you know, Jesus wept and all that. But this is one of the first scriptures that I actually studied to memorize. In verses 1 and 2, it says, shout for joy to the Lord, all ye the earth. Worship the Lord with gladness. Come before him with joyful songs. And you know, that's what it is. God wants us to shout to all the earth that God is the Father. God is the King of all kings, the Creator, the Comforter, the beginning, the end, the Alpha and Omega. Jesus gives us eternal and divine perspective. He wants us to stop thinking about what's in front of us, but think of what there is to come. Let me say that again. He wants us to stop thinking of what's in front of us, but think of what there is to come. Let me illustrate that. Yeah? Say, have you ever been to a steakhouse that serves peanuts at the table? Or sometimes even in the waiting area? Yeah? And when you do that, you don't want to eat too much peanuts, right? Because what happens when you eat too much of the peanuts? And you know why they put the peanuts there, right? Because the portions they serve might not the kind, you know, not the kind, local kind, big boy servings. You ever been to those little fancy dinners? Everything looks so pretty, but you can see a lot of plate more than you can see food. You know, some of you've been to some of these, right? And what happens after you leave? Yeah, so like if you go to like a big ball and all of that, or a wedding, someplace fancy wedding, and you get all these fancy dining. When you pop, where you go, zippies or something, right? Because you're still not full. Yeah, it doesn't fill you up. Yeah. So, you know, you got to watch that you don't eat too much peanuts and it don't fill you up. And then what? Because your steak is coming. Yeah? So God is telling us the same thing. He says, don't get bogged down by what's in front of you. Yeah? That we forget what's important. Yeah? Don't get bogged down But persecutions, that we forget the importance of sharing the gospel. Don't fear persecution, hatred, or rejection. Fear the creator of all things. Fear the King of kings, the sovereign God of the universe. That's what our scripture is telling us, to be bold. To be bold to proclaim the message. Let me show you two more scriptures for this section. In Psalms 112, verse 1, he says, "Praise the Lord. Blessed are those who fear the Lord, who find great delight in his commands." Yeah? God wants us to share the gospel. And what? God delights in, he's overjoyed when we just follow his commands and not let others bog us down from sharing the gospel. Our next scripture, Proverbs 19:23. Should I just touch on the thing supposed to? Oh, you did? Okay. Proverbs 19:23. It says, "The fear of the Lord leads to life. Then one rests content, untouched by trouble." Yeah. Like I said, God is our protector. We fear him because we know he's got our back. The devil cannot touch us. The only time the devil can touch us is if we allow him to. If we allow things to upset us and take our focus off of the Lord. That's what it is. Yeah. He loves that. The devil doesn't want you to keep focus on him, but God, he loves it when you just focus on him. He's got our back. He's our comforter. He's our protector. He will protect you from all of that. And I tell you what, it is better to die a hard life knowing that you have your salvation than it's better to die a good, easy life without salvation. Hear what I'm saying? Don't let the devil steal your joy. Don't give in to the worldly stress of this world. Turn, God says, cast all your burdens, all your cares upon him, and he will give us rest. Take the yoke upon you. Take his yoke upon you. Yeah? Give your cares to him and just take God's word with you. And when we can focus more on that, life becomes easy, even though it is hard. Even though we live in this, you know, even though you would, if you had God through your whole pandemic, it wasn't as bad as it seems. Why? Because we know that God was in control, was always in control. God provided. If you're still here and you didn't suffer from, you know, did you lose your house? Did you lose your food? And we might have not had a job for a while, but God still provided. Maybe he wasn't eating like before, like going out eating all, you know, all the fancy stuff. But God still provided, right? Even if you didn't have a house, God still provided a place for you to live. God provides. Yeah. Believe it or not, man, I remember being homeless for about 3 years. It was before the pandemic. So when the pandemic came, it was like nothing to us. It was just, okay, God, you in charge. It's just testing our faith. How strong is our faith in him? Let's get to the next section. I know everybody is like texting me, and I swear I shut off all these stuff, but Hallelujah. God is good. Our next section, we're going to take on the rest, the last two verses of our, or three verses of our scripture today. So first is to boldly share the message. And you need this part too, is to boldly trust God. Yeah, that's basically what we've been talking about. Yeah, in verses 29 to 31, he says, are not two sparrows sold for a penny? Yet not one of them will fall to the ground outside of your Father's care. Not even a hair on your head. Every hair on your head is numbered. I mean, God knows everything about you. In fact, he created you in his image. So he knows every speck, everything in your life. You cannot hide nothing from him. But don't be afraid. You are worth more to him than those two sparrows. Well, all the sparrows. See, Jesus uses the sparrows as an illustration of his love for them. Yeah? And the sparrow was one of the cheapest animals in Israel at that time. Yeah? You could buy it on sparrow for like pennies. Yeah? Yet he says not even one of those cheap sparrows will be harmed. That's what he illustrated with the to his disciples with the sparrows. None of them will be harmed without God's consent, he says. Yeah? Yet we are his children, his heirs to his throne. He says God knows everything about us, even every little strand of your hair. And Jesus put these two facts to prove that God can be trusted. Jesus tells his disciples, you can trust in my Father. Yeah? He says, we are known by God. That we are more significant than anything else of all creations. You know that? That you and I are more significant than anything else that God created. And we can trust in him. And that's how the disciples got to put their faith and trust in God, because Jesus told them to trust in him. We are more important than anything else that he created. Let me share with you a scripture in Jeremiah 17, verse 7 and 8. It says in Jeremiah, blessed is the one who trusts in the Lord, whose confidence is in him. In verse 8, he says, they will be like a tree planted by the water that sends out its roots by the stream. It does not fear when the heat comes. Its leaves are always green. It has no worries in a year of drought and never fails to bear fruit. You see, we need not to worry about persecution or conflicts. Because God has got this. He is in total control. And he's got your back. He has called us. He equipped us. And he also commissioned us. And he commands us to go out and share the gospel. And he says what? He tells his disciples just before he leaves, I'm going to leave, so I want you guys to carry on. Take it out to the streets. Shout from the rooftops and share the gospel to the ends of the earth. And that same command he also, and that same commission that he had to the disciples is also commissioned and commands for us. To go out and share his gospel. And he says, hey, don't worry. He will also guide us. He will guide you on where and how. And then he will also protect us. He's got your back. He's got you covered. And he also will comfort us. Because why? We're going to go through these times where we need comfort. And when who we lean on more, when we struggle, when we're going through these struggling dark times, we need to lean on God and lean on His Word and trust in Him. Because He's got you. He's got you. We just need to know that and trust Him more than we trust the devil. In fact, just kick him to the side, the devil. Just put your full trust in him. Because the final part is what? Not only that he'll guide, protect, and comfort us, but what? He will reward us. That's the ultimate thing, that he will reward us with salvation, eternal life. See, Jesus, he sent his son here to die for our sins so that we could have eternal life. And when he died on the cross for our sins, he set us free. You know what does that mean, to be set free? Yeah? It's not just that we set free. It's mean to be set free from our sins. It means you have a choice now. See, before you never had a choice because you was born into sin. Because of what Adam and Eve done. We were all born into sin. And God sent his son to pay the price for all of those sins. Before sins you commit now, submit, and the sins you will commit in the future, God paid the price for all of that. But we need to make the choice to remain set free or still chained. You're not chained to sin anymore. You have a choice to make. You have a choice not to give in to worldly desires and sin. You have a choice to be set and kept free and get salvation. See, God is in total control. Even when we can't see the outcome, he knows what is best for us. Let me share with you one more scripture. One last scripture in Matthew chapter 28. And I'm going to read from verse 18 to verse 20. And it says in 18, then Jesus came to them and said, all authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all the nations, and baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely, there's always that encouragement part in his scriptures. And surely, I am with you always. Underline that word, always. I am with you always to the very end of the age. What is the very end? The end times is when he comes back to take us home. He's telling us that to obey his commands. And surely he's with us all the way through. Even when you think he's not there, you're struggling through stressful times. Remember this line that he is. He says, you can underline sure, and surely, that's a positive note right there. That's a promise that he's always with us, always, to the very end of age. You see, church, the truth of the matter is this. Christians cannot live in fear. We cannot live in fear, generally speaking. And we certainly cannot live in fear when it comes to sharing the message of Jesus Christ, the gospel. And, you know, to illustrate this, for Memorial Day, the Kanaka Ohana decided to go down to Naples to visit some friends from when they used to live there. And one of their favorite things to do in Naples is to walk on the Naples Pier. Now, one of the sons named Kimo, he was fearful to walk on the pier. So he said, Dad. His dad's name is Kavika. So his dad, Kavika, assured him that it was worth walking on the pier. Even if he's afraid, because it's such a fun experience. So Kimo, he mustered up the courage and he walked on the pier with the rest of his Ohana. And when they got to the end, they got to see a dolphin up close with the rest of his, they got to see a dolphin up close. And Kimo was delighted. You see, he would have missed the most excitement of the trip if he let fear keep him from the pier. Listen, church, we have the great joy and privilege to be used by God to reach others with the gospel. We have been blessed. We have a blessing of living a life in devotion and obedience to our Father and Savior. We must not let fear keep us from faithfully following our Father. We must not miss out because we are afraid. We must not let the devil steal our joy that we have when we reach the end of this walk on the pier. Let our fear of God and our trust in God drive us to be bold in our faith. What is the question for us today? Are you bold to go where only chosen men have gone before? That's the question. Yeah, it's kind of like that. Are you bold? Star Trek, right? To go where no one has gone before or whatever. Yeah. That kind of came to my mind. Are we bold to go where only chosen men and women have gone before? The bottom line is that to be bold and fear and trust God. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Lord, we want to praise and thank you for this scripture. We want to thank you for the encouragement that you give us to be bold. Because why? Because we want to bring joy and happiness to you. And we know that sharing your word, your gospel, brings joy to your face. And not just because it brings joy, but it also secures us of our salvation, Lord. And Lord, we know that the struggles, the persecutions, the fears of this world, the hatred in this world, is all yet temporary. Let us not get bogged down by the worldly stuff, but to keep our eyes focused on you. Because when we keep our eyes focused and our hearts focused on you, we secure our salvation. And Lord, once again, we praise and thank you for setting us free from sin, that now we have a choice to sin or to be more like you each day. And Lord, we want to choose to be more like you and not get sucked into the devil's trap. Let us choose wisely. And always remember, this is the temporary world. Let us focus on the future, because that's really important. If we're going to focus on this world, we know where we're going to end up. But when we focus on our future, we know where we're going to be. Great is our reward in heaven, where you have gone to prepare a place for each and every one of us. Thank you, Lord. I thank you for your words, your scriptures, that you continue to pour into our hearts. Let us not be afraid, but to be bold to go out and share everything you have taught us. Bless the hearts that are here. Bless our fathers, that they continue to hear you, Lord, that they continue to follow you, Lord, and that they continue to release what is worldly that's hindering them or bogging them down from reaching you. Bless our dads on this Father's Day. And Lord, we praise and thank you, our Father in heaven, our King of kings, Lord of lords, the great and mighty creator of all of us. We pray this in your precious, your holy name. And everybody says, amen. Falling in love with Jesus. Falling in love with Jesus. Falling in love with Jesus was the best thing I've ever done. Come on, church, sing with me, falling in love with Jesus. Falling in love with Jesus. Falling in love with Jesus. Falling in love with Jesus was the best thing I've ever. Oh, in his arms, never disconnected. In his arms, I feel protected. There's no place I'd rather be. Sing it. In his arms. It's in his arms. In his arms, I feel protected. Oh, in his arms, never disconnected. Yeah. In his arms, I feel. love you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for this day. Thank you for coming into our hearts in our worship this morning. For the words of wisdom that we can be bold, we can glorify you and not worry about anything else. Not letting anything stop us or from stealing our joy. So Lord, we thank you again. And we give you all honor. We give you all praise. Because Lord, we love you. Fall in love with Jesus. Falling in love with Jesus. Falling in love with Jesus is the best thing I've ever done. Yes, it's the best thing I've ever done. It's the best thing I've ever done. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. All right, church. Thank you guys so much for joining us. So once again, a big, big happy Father's Day to all you dads out there. You guys have a blessed, a beautiful day. Kids, wives, love on your dad, love on your husbands today. And don't forget our kupunas. Love on them. They paved the way for all of us. I want to praise and thank our Heavenly Father. We want to thank Him and shout out to Him. Give Him praises this morning. For God is good all the time. He never fails. And all the time, God is good. Let us close our service this morning and go to the Lord in prayer. Lord, we just want to praise and thank you for this day. We want to praise and thank you. Thank you for the dads, especially our dads that step up. And always there for to take care of their family, Lord. Want to praise and thank you for them that all they pour into it, that they never forget to pour into you first. Because when we pour into you first, and we give you first attention in our lives, everything else falls into place. Your provisions, your comfort. They all fall into place to care for our families, to provide for our needs, put a roof over our head, clothes on our backs, food on our table. Is when we put you first, we know that you will provide for all of our needs. So let us not worry and be bogged down by the stressfulness of life today. Let us keep our eyes focused on tomorrow. Today is not promised. Let us worry about our salvation and what is promised. And Lord, I pray that each and every one of us, that if you was to take us today, we will all be ready and we will all be on that train to heaven when you come to take us home. And Lord, I want to ask that you want to ask prayers for those who are dealing with or suffering, for those who are feeling so emotional about today. And life today. For all of the children and wives who have lost their dads, their husbands, it's a hard day for them today, Lord. I want to pray for them that you comfort them, knowing that they're in a better place, that they will see them again. As long as we focus on you, that will happen. let us not worry about worldly stuff. Let us put you first, because we know you will take care of all of the worldly stuff. We praise and thank you for the message today. Let us be bold to go out and share this message with others that you put in our paths. Bless the hearts that are here, that they may have a blessed, blessed day and a great week, and we see them again next week for more encouraging words from you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Praises. We praise your name. We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor and praises. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, church, we want to thank you guys for joining us today. Happy Father's Day once again to all you men out there. Speaking of men, don't forget, next men's ministry we're going to do is the first Saturday of the month, like normal. We're just changing the time from in the morning to the afternoon, and we're going to change it, and we're going to do it face-to-face, fellowship live, face-to-face. You don't have to worry. We got a ministry center, and we can use one side of our ministry center, one of our booths, to just to fellowship. Yeah. Okay? So you guys have any questions, you have any other prayer requests, you can leave it in a message here. You can privately text me or instant message me, or you can call me. But please don't text and call me doing service at 8:30 to like about now. It's about 10. So between 8:30 and 10, please try not to text me or call me. Unless you want everybody to know and see your message, that's fine. All right? I want to praise and thank you guys for joining us. You guys have a blessed day in the Lord. We love you guys, and we see you, folks. Hey, by the way, pray for my wife. She's not feeling well. Hopefully she feels better. Tomorrow is Monday Melee. We do like we're still doing live, even though COVID looks like it's been over. And also pineapple squeeze juice. Wednesdays, if you want to come and see us, come on down. Look, see, they're calling me already, I tell you. Unbelievable. Anyway, we love you guys, and you guys have a blessed day in the name of God. Amen.
Because of your love.
You're the one who is making us new. You're the one who is bringing us healing. We owe it all to you. Because of your love, we're forgiven. Because of your love, our hearts are clean. We lift you up with songs. Have a great day in the Lord, you guys. I love you guys. Aloha. Happy Father's Day.
Lift up the name of Jesus. Lift up his holy name. Lift up the name of Jesus. Come, let us give him praise. Come, let us glorify the Lord Most High. Sing.